my trusty side, my sidekick, my co-host, my partner in crime, an extra in the fighter. Mike, I think you were in the fighter, right? Mike Malloy is here. Mike.
Hello, Danny. How are we?
I'm great. It's always good to see you. I love you dearly. Melissa Leo was really nice on set, right? You can at least say she was really nice. She was like mean in the movie, but she was really nice.
I would never set foot in Lowell, Massachusetts. So I'm
okay. All right. Well, hopefully Lowell isn't watching. You know, Josh Gondel, people from Boston watch this thing, I think.
What do they get? What are they going to hook a fucking iPad up to a car battery that they jumped?
They might. Please don't hurt us, Lowell, Massachusetts. All right, so we already got that city upset. But with us, everyone give a little wave to our amazing contestants. We're going to introduce them as the round goes on. If you have never seen the show before, it is a drunk spelling bee. So the rules are we have 8 contestants all competing for the right to say that they won a spelling bee for adults. And we've got 5 rounds. The first 4 rounds are preliminary, and they're going to keep increasing in difficulty, and you get points as it – so round one's going to be – sort of a lob, and you'll get 1 point for that round, and it's going to increase in difficulty to round 4. After those rounds, Mike's going to use Microsoft Excel to add up the points, and the top 4 people are in the finals, and we're just going to go right through it until we have a winner. Our defending champion, Dave Ross, is with us. Dave, it was an intense final round, right? I mean, it wasn't too scary, but...
Yeah, it was, I think it was pretty scary for me, just because I knew what would happen if I lost.
yes.
Which would be that I would get to not appear on another drunk spelling bee. And yeah, I couldn't take that chance.
David, too kind.
Yeah, see how nice I can be?
I mean, terrific. Incredibly nice. I mean, I'm still trying to find weddings to go with you. I mean, we're still going to be, we're going to Owen Wilson and Vince Vaughn.
Oh, yeah. You guys got a whole summer of black weddings.
Yeah.
I don't remember the last, I guess the last and evidently most sincere bonding. I don't recall very well, but it sounds like we made some fun plans and that's.
Yeah. Cool. I mean, we were both drinking whiskey. I was drinking, you were drinking. I definitely forgot about it. But okay, here we go. Contestants, the rules of the bee, very simple. And you don't really even have to follow them. Whatever. Have fun. Drink. The only rule is if you get the word right, everybody else drinks. If you get the word wrong, then you drink. That's it. That's all it is. But some people like to drink even when they're not spelling. Some people are drinking during different words. You know, it's not, I'm not, you,
you
know,
spell
I'm
it
not,
right
I'm not
you want
a
to
cop.
Celebrate, you can drink for that. But like, you know, there's no rules really.
I have all the definitions of the words. Mike will use words and sentences if you need them. They will not be helpful sentences. Just keep that in mind. So here we go. Let's get the show on the road. I'm going to introduce our guests as we begin round one. So let's kick it off. I told them who is in order, so they should know who's going, but you know, let's see if they remember. A defector staff writer and co-owner Luis is here with us. Luis, how are you, sir?
I'm good. I've been drinking since 4 p.m. so you know.
Oh yeah, I should take a sip of something.
Cheers to that.
Cheers to that.
Right, absolutely. All right, so we got that's the spirit, because you know, it's spelling bees are hard. Have you ever competed in a spelling bee before, Luis?
I actually did my first one during quarantine, and it was a drunk spelling bee as well, and I won. Not to put pressure on all my competitors here. I'm not
gonna win that. Oh yeah, no pressure, but I've done this format before and I won that. So
real quick though, I do want to shout out the shirt that I am wearing.
I'm
just honoring our defending champion here.
That is a picture of me.
Oh, delightful. Yeah. If anyone else has shirts of pictures of people, Mike, you have a Chris Cubas shirt, right?
I do.
Right? Break it out at some point.
All right. If there's...
Luis, we should do this. We should start this round one. The first word in the faded drunk spelling bee. Your word is fight.
I don't want to get this wrong, so give me the definition, please.
Okay. To take part in a violent struggle involving the exchange of physical blows or the use of weapons.
F-I-G-H-T.
That is how you spell fight. That is correct.
There we go.
6 for everyone. There we go.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Boom, boom. That's the level of round one words if anyone was nervous. People get nervous. They're like, am I going to fuck up round one? No, you'll be all right. I mean, unless you do, then I'm
we'll
sorry.
See.
I was going to say I set you up for failure. But batting second, one of the hosts of the Green Zoom podcast, Maggie Maye, is here. Maggie, how are you doing?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm good. Hanging out, drinking a little bit. It's a terrible German beer called Benediktiner. Don't drink it, guys. Or maybe it's probably been sitting in the fridge for too long. What are you drinking, Maggie?
Tequila and White Claw.
Amazing.
Hold on, together? Did you say tequila, like a tequila and White Claw in a cocktail?
A tequila White Claw cocktail. No, I took a tequila shot. And
like, damn, that girl.
If you do that with like an ounce of OJ and a shot of grenadine, it makes a fucking pretty good tequila sunrise.
Oh, okay. Learn something new every. All right, sweet.
We learned that on the Neela taught us that on the happy.
Yeah, hour. I mean, I was hammered, so I don't remember what we make on a happy hour together. I mean, sometimes I do. So Maggie, have you ever won a spelling bee in the past? Have you competed? Are you a veteran of the spelling bees like Luis?
Yeah, I used to do spelling bees when I was a kid. I'm a good speller.
All right, sweet. All right, another front runner. And are you ready for your first word of this spelling bee, which is candy?
Jay? No, I'm kidding. C-A-N-D-Y, candy.
That is correct. There we
go, on the board.
There we go, we're moving.
Oh, right.
Moving and grooving. Oh, yeah.
Sippy, sippy.
Batting third. The host of the Bad Advice Podcast with Chris Cubas. Chris Cubas is here. Chris, how are you doing?
I'm good. I'll have you know, I was in a dog obedience class with one Melissa Leo about 20 years
what?
Ago.
What?
Yeah, I lived in upstate New York, and she lived there. It's like near Woodstock, and we took our dogs to the same fucking dog obedience class. She was very nice. No slander.
She was nice. Was she nice to the dog?
Oh no, she kicked the dogs, but she was nice to me. So,
oh, damn it! Damn it. I knew it. Always the nice ones who are mean to the dogs. Mm-hmm. Chris, how are you doing, sir?
I'm good. I just finished a hurricane. I'm having a little whiskey. Ooh, I'll have to finish another. I'll get another drink in a minute. Yeah, I thought that was the point. No, I was invited to a drunk spelling bee, and everyone's like, "Oh, we better be mindful."
Yeah, you get drunk throughout it. I mean, I had a Celtics game to watch before. I'm catching the next little buzz, you know me.
No, you're doing it right, Chris. Yeah. Are you a veteran of the spelling bee game? Have you competed in past?
As a child, I was in spelling bees in school. Like, I never won, and then I co-hosted a drunk spelling bee with one Blake Midget. Shout out to Blake Midget once here in Austin. And I just got hammered and roasted people until some dude wanted to fight me and they made me leave. So that's my experience with drunk spelling bees. We'll see if I can do the same over Zoom.
Well, there we go. I don't know if you can throw hands over Zoom, but we'll see tonight. Here we go. Yeah. If anyone wants to fight over Zoom, let's do this. But your round one word and the drunk bounce for the drunk spelling bee is sneaker.
Give me a definition.
Definition of sneaker is a soft shoe with a rubber sole worn for sports or casual occasions.
S-N-E-A-K-E-R, sneaker.
Chris, that is correct.
Cheers. Mm-mm-mm. Celebrate. There we go, on the
Cheers.
Board. Big
three
six.
For
three.
Tally my drinks, I gotta get a drink.
Absolutely. Yeah, there. If it's not your turn, please.
Oh, hold yeah. If it's not your turn, just Dakota. Leave your camera on, because otherwise it'll fuck Kenny's shit up, but like, go do what you gotta do.
All right, batting fourth, batting cleanup. A comedian and host of the Funny Lingus comedy show, Ellory Smith, is here. Ellory, how are you doing?
Hi, it's so nice to see you guys.
Good to see you. Are you a veteran of spelling bees? Have you ever competed in spelling bees in years past?
I've actually never done a spelling bee. I went to a school that was not very serious. didn't learn any geography or spelling, so it's gonna be a wild ride for me.
All right. Well, what are you drinking at least to help with the spelling?
I combined red wine, or not red wine, rosé, and orange soda, but a fancy orange soda.
Ooh, there you go. Ooh, Pellegrino. Okay.
Oh. All right.
I'm a little bit drunk already, so go eat.
Hey. Again, it's the point of the show. So we're cooking with gas now. We're doing what we're doing. All right, Ellory, your word in the first round of the Faded Drunk Spelling Bee is window.
Like Rear Window?
Like the film Rear Window.
Or the front one. Or the side one.
Whatever. Or the side one.
Could be like wherever.
Wherever.
But like Rear Window, yes.
W-I-N-D-O-W, window.
Yeah. That is how you spell That's window.
It. I had to write
you know what, it could also be above you. It could be on top.
Anyway, Ellory, any way it counts.
That's a skylight, actually.
Ooh, I mean, if it moves, or but like if it's just if it doesn't, it's just a window.
Mike, don't mansplain skylighting. It's the first round. Jesus Christ.
Listen, no, I'm talking about in a car.
Oh, I don't know.
I've never had a convertible. I'm still young.
Well, you can't really have a sunroof in a convertible though, because it's like.
Mike, what are we doing? Let's not talk about car parts. This isn't a car. This isn't a drunk car parts show. I'm not.
Listen, it's me, Jay Leno. This is the plan the whole time. I've been hosting this show.
The first rule I made.
I got a whole suit of denim in the other room that I got to throw on.
I was
going to
say, the first rule I said Conan, absolutely on this, but no jeans, no Leno, no big garages of cars. Absolutely not. Leno will not return our calls, but you know what? That doesn't matter. Shocker.
What's up?
And Dakota. Batting.
Oh, yeah, she's here for moral support.
Oh, that's
yes. Dakota, oh my God, okay. She's resting on your arm like an angel.
She's a good dog.
Is.
I love her. She doesn't respect me at all, and she's my favorite.
She doesn't. It's so
hey,
funny.
You know what? That's all right with me. Look
she
at
put
that
a
face.
Hole in my couch earlier. She's so mean to me.
Yeah, man. She means, why not? You probably deserved it. I mean, no, you
did. I did.
Shocker, how are you doing?
I'm all right.
Thanks for coming in. You are the Miguel Cairo. You are the Wilson Bedemi. Those were for Dave Roth.
Yeah,
of this drunk spelling bee. You are a utility man, a fill-in. So thank you for filling in. It's always a blast to have you. Were you sipping on something before we called you?
Oh yes. If the fine folks at Topo Chico would like to listen in for a second, I just want to shout out their amazing hard seltzers and ask that if they'd like to deliver any of these or just regular Topo Chico to my house at any time, I am here and ready to accept.
I love how you're pandering for an alcohol sponsorship. Like, me and Danny haven't been running a fucking cocktail making show for a fucking year.
Because somehow
you fucking dime from it.
And you want to know
how so much has got a free case from a single fucking company yet? You're gonna get some Topo Chico?
Because despite my lapses in judgment, my tweets are still only half as incendiary as yours.
That's true. Yeah. And incendiary is a good word. All right. Shocker's going to do well. Shocker, the first.
I don't know. I lost in like the third round last time.
I don't remember. I mean, you were also drinking triples.
We'll I was real fucked up.
Shocker, in round one of this, our fifth spelling bee, your word is garnish.
Garnish. What do you think?
Oh my God. If she spoke it.
G A R N I S H.
G A R N I S H. Hold on.
Did I get that?
That's right. That is right. Okay. That is correct. That is correct.
Go team.
Tips for everybody. Go team. Go. 5 for 5. Moving and grooving. Up next, the author of Well, This Is Exhausting, Sophia Benoit is here. Sophia, hello. How are you doing?
Hi. I want to start out by saying that everyone else is like, I spell fine, other than Ellory, but I'm dyslexic, so this is going to be a real fun time for everyone. And when Mike invited me on here, I was like, I don't know if I'm allowed, but I'm going to try it. So here we go. If you're ready
Absolutely.
For losing the first round, I'm ready.
I absolutely, everyone is encouraged to participate. And also, this thing happens every single B where the person who says they're going to lose and is the worst ends up like making the final or winning. So like, yeah. I know, like, I can see this being an angle where it's like, what a story, what an arc. But
yeah, it's gonna be like Miracle on Ice, but like for yeah. me personally.
Yes, personal miracle. So yeah. I am Russia, am I the USSR?
Yes, yeah. Everyone else is kind of Russia. I'm the United States, Herb Brooks. I'm nailing
cool.
it.
Amazing.
The hot hockey players.
Yeah, I'm like all of the hot hockey players in that movie.
Yes. I don't know any of the, I don't, Mike Ruzioni, I think is one.
Yeah.
Jim Craig. Okay. I do know the roster.
Ruzioni was supposed to show up to one of my college classes once. And then the day before, a different professor walked into our class and told us our actual professor fell down the stairs and then had a heart attack. He lived.
Jesus.
But what a fucking bang, bang, terrible situation.
And then did the guy not show up?
Or did he push him down the stairs?
Ruzioni didn't show up because he was friends with that teacher. Or that professor.
It kind of makes you wonder why he didn't show up after that.
I think he did it.
To that teacher, that makes me want to ask, do you believe in miracles?
Jesus Christ.
To me, yes. All right, dark, morbid humor. Sophia, round one. Here we go. Are you ready for your first word?
I'm maybe. We'll see.
All right. Well, here we go. Your first word is carpool.
Oh, C-A-R-P-O-O-L.
That is correct.
Yes. Okay.
Oh, boom.
I can quit now. I'm good.
There it is. All right. Thank you, Sophia, for joining us. Undefeated, batting 1,000. The only person. Faded history. I mean, there's definitely, I think Josh Gondelman. Eh, whatever. We'll skip it. Batting 7th. Who we got? We got Tej. We got Tej, who is Tej underscore, or no, less underscore humble Tej on Twitter. Tej, welcome to the program. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you. And I forgot to tell Danny, but I'm also on a podcast. It's called the One Take Podcast. We talk about movies.
He's also on a podcast called the One Take Podcast, and they talk about movies. What was the last movie that you guys talked about on the pod?
We just talked about Gladiator, Russell Crowe, the greatest sports movie of all time.
Sports movie?
That's a sports movie.
Oh, yeah, it is. It's combat.
Yeah, that's a sports movie.
Or the arena, I guess. The arena is a sport. No, what is the sport they're doing? Gladiator?
Gladiating.
Gladiating.
Gladiating. Russell Crowe, what a run. What a run.
It's
for
kind
Russell
of fucked up that they jacked that whole thing from American Gladiators.
Yeah.
They it's had basically DC a hardcore Humvee. Match. That's basically what it is.
Wow. I mean, I would rewatch that movie. Russell Crowe, what a run he had for the late 90s to the Master and Commander, a little Beautiful Mind action, a little Gladiator. He stopped and threw some phones at people's heads in between, I think, from what I remember. But other than that,
100-odd foot of grunts. Was that his band?
It was.
Am I right
he
about
had
that?
A band, too.
Am I got crazy? Yeah.
100-odd foot of grunts. That's a pull.
Do I get bonus point? Is there extra
credit? No, this isn't a fucking Russell Crowe beat.
That's 3 points.
You fucking ding dog.
That's a hell of a reference.
Russell Crowe trivia.
Oh, all right. Well, Tej, welcome to the Spelling Bee Arena. Your first word in this round is guitar.
Guitar. G-U-I-T-A-R. Guitar.
That's how you spell guitar. Boom.
Cheers.
We're 7-7. 7-7. And to round it out, the defending champion, editor and co-owner at Defector, co-host of the Distracting Podcast, and my wedding running man, David Roth, is here. David, how are you doing, sir?
I'm good, man. How are you?
I'm good. Good. Good to see you. Good to have
How's
you back.
How's the first
how
round
you...
going? I haven't been paying much attention. It seems like everyone's having fun.
Everyone's gotten every word right.
Oh, great.
They've been talking unrelenting shit about Defector. I didn't stop them. I was going to stop them.
No, you
and then
should.
They were
it's
like,
not...
no.
It's not your place.
Even okay. I talk shit about Defector.
Yeah.
Yeah. I was like, wow, this is kind of crazy. But you know what? Now we're here. Do you feel more confident, less confident that you're the defending champion entering to defend your crown?
I mean, to a certain extent, I now know that, like, I can spell... I think the last word I had was the name of a dog breed. So, like, if I've had, like, 5 drinks in 2 hours, I can spell a harder-than-average dog breed name, which is not something I knew about myself before, you know, we did this last time.
I mean, we're trying to educate people on this. You know, spelling bees are to educate. The alcohol is just for fun.
Right.
So, David, your first round word in this, our faded drunk spelling bee, is movie.
Oh, cool. I love those. M-O-V-I-E, movie.
That is how you spell movie, and that is a perfect round one.
Perfect first round.
There we go.
We did it, you guys.
We did it.
We did it. All right. Thanks for coming, everybody. That was fun. Now we got to keep pushing along into round two. The words are getting a little bit harder, a little bit escalating. We'll see how we go. I got absolutely eviscerated because the words were too easy. And to be fair, I mean, only John Gabris got one word wrong, and then he was the only person who got a word wrong, and everyone else spelled it perfectly. So
that was,
you know,
these are definitely because he wanted to eat dinner. Like that.
That was so. He was like, I'm sipping weed tea. Like I'm on Mars. Like I know he has like 3 podcasts that all take between 2 and 3. So he was just burnt out. And I was like, thank you for doing this. Please, you have a family. And so shout out to Gabris. Thanks for doing the show. All right, round two. Here we go. We're starting it up. Luis, we're back to you.
Let's do it.
Here we go. Your round two word is ballyhoo.
Okay. I did not know that was a real word, so I'm just winging this. Actually, no, hold on. Mike, can I get that in a sentence?
There was much ballyhoo about the event.
Wow.
Okay, that didn't help at all.
It means extravagant publicity or fuss.
All right, I'm going for it. B-A-L-L-Y-H-O-O.
That is correct.
Oh, let's
there
go.
There we go.
I'm gonna drink amazing. For that.
No one's, yeah, ever, that's tough, oh, yeah. Tough words always, tough buckets, we love. Oh, wait, I don't think anyone's used that word since the 40s, but that's what we do.
I've definitely used it in a sentence, like, in the last decade.
Really? Because it did not sound like you have used it since when you were like... No,
fucking nerd.
I was probably being a dickhead while I used it, but I,
yeah.
You know.
I mean, we that can assume.
Sense. Yeah, no, I know.
Yeah. Mike being a dickhead? No.
No, that seems unlikely.
Hey, anyway, I'm fucking like, what? Let's watch no it problem. There, Danny.
I know. I can't. I mean, I'm gonna. Yeah, I was gonna say I can't have you turning on me because then I'll have no one. Maggie Maye, here we go. Are you ready for round two?
I'm ready.
Here we go. Your word is beguile.
Beguile.
Ooh,
that was swift,
that
and that was
ooh,
correct.
She knew that
wow.
shit.
Okay.
She knew that shit. God damn.
If the sports books are still open, Maggie Maye's odds are rising.
Biking.
She's smart. Yeah.
Taking another shot.
Yeah.
And she's taking another shot. She doesn't give
it's
a
back,
shit.
It's back.
God damn. Let's go. That's a heat
let's
check.
Go.
That's a heat check if I ever saw one. All right, well, she's taking a shot. Chris Cubas, we're back to you for your second round word.
I'm scared.
Your second round word
mm-hmm.
is carcinogen.
Oh, son of a bitch. That is so much harder than beguile. Okay. C-A-R C-I N-O-G-E-N. Carcinogen.
That is correct. He got it. That was a toughie in round two. That was amazing.
Oh, I'm probably I'm just going to drink on all the things.
Oh,
that's pretty
that's my strategy.
I'm not even in
tonight.
The shit and I'm
yeah. Well, yeah, you're not in the competition. It doesn't count if you're just drunk as well.
I feel like you should keep drinking and then at some point you'll like attain a higher level of brain power.
Yeah, yeah. No, that's my goal is to drink into a second level of consciousness.
Yeah, same here.
Which is often called unconsciousness.
That's how John Daly got into the zone. Go for John Daly. If I drink enough vodka, Arnold Palmer's, I'll be on the moon. I hope he's doing okay. I think he's probably in a hospital somewhere. So, John, hang in there, buddy. But in the meanwhile, Ellory, round two. Are you ready for your round two word? Yes, maybe. All right, here we go. Your word in round two is inconsiderate.
Okay, I-N-C-O-N-S-I-D-E-R-A-T-E, inconsiderate.
That is correct.
Got it.
Boom.
Cheers.
Blush. Ooh. Ones, it's fun. It's fun when the long ones are good. Shocker, Dakota.
How are we doing?
Ready?
Oh, hold on. Is that dog drinking or what? What are we doing here?
Yeah, hold on. What's going on here?
Yeah.
She destroyed my couch. I don't want to say
that's true. Dogs can't. I'm just gonna say this, and I'm gonna say it out loud. Dogs can never, ever, ever drink alcohol, right? That's a hard and
probably,
fast.
Probably. I'm not. Yeah, I'm not gonna find out.
They can.
Yeah.
Wait, Sophia, they can?
Best friend's mom's dog is addicted to alcohol, and if anyone has it, she'll go beg for it in front of them, and she loves it.
Look, as we all know,
it's alcohol and not just like a liquid.
That feels like a dependency.
I mean, they're it's a poodle. They're smart. I don't know.
They're French. They start drinking wine real early.
She's a winer. That's the problem.
She loves wine. If you have a glass of wine, like you can put it on your fingers and she would like beg for it and lick it off. So dogs.
Didn't the blonde girl from Love is Blind? Didn't the blonde girl from Love is Blind catch heat for like sharing red wine with her dog and everyone was like, what the fuck are you doing?
It's wrong,
but they can, you know? Yeah.
Yeah.
You're allowed to give horses.
They shouldn't.
That's obviously.
They really shouldn't.
Yeah.
No, Dakota is only 2 years old. She's underage. I can't.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
That's true. Next year, Dakota's 21 in dog years. Here we go. We're going to the bars. The dog. How is there? Oh, there are dog bars. That's a thing. I've been to a dog bar. It's fun.
Yeah.
Yeah, I live around white people. There's a lot of dog
bars. Yeah.
Any dog's a dog bar if it's got an outside.
Dog bars and cat cafes. Wait, where were we? Shocker, yes. Shocker in Dakota. Shocker, your word in round two is neurosis.
Neurosis. N-E-U-R-O-S-I-S.
That is correct.
Sweet.
Boom. Cooking with gas.
There we go. Cheers.
Is it gross gas?
We're not doing this.
Yeah.
Not
doing gross gas. GG's. GG's all around. Oh, all right. We're 14 for no, 12 for 12 word wise. Let's see if Sophia.
Don't you worry. Things will be changing.
Sophia, your word in the second round of the Faded Drunk Spelling Bee is gimmicky.
Oh, fuck. I think that has two M's. Okay, G-I-M-M-I-C-K-Y.
Got it.
It does, in fact, have two M's. That is correct.
Yeah. Fuck.
There okay, it is.
We're done. This is making me so nervous, but this means nothing. This means absolutely nothing.
Yeah,
it means nothing, and I'm terrified, Sophia. Yeah, I totally feel you.
There are no stakes here.
I'm sweating, though.
Who's line rules?
This feels like college. Don't.
Oh, yes. The winner of this will get a full ride to South Texas Connecticut A&M. State. Texas A&M. Yeah, yes.
Giga. Oh, I love it.
Giga. Johnny Manziel, annual scholarship. Yeah, boo. I was like, he drinks, right? I was thinking of someone who drinks. Johnny Manziel. Hopefully he's
he drinks the bad way.
Yeah.
Like the way that like Ellery's mom's friend's dog drinks is how Johnny.
I met Johnny Manziel one time at a pool. He was being very rude.
That sounds right.
Believe
that
it.
That sounds right.
A drunk football player.
That entire sentence sounds incredibly believable.
That is maybe the most on-brand sentence that you could say about that man.
Yeah.
I met him at a pool, and he was very rude.
Yeah, very rude.
Well, fuck Johnny Manziel. I hope you aren't in a pool right now.
He subscribes, but still, fuck him. Kenny, block him. Kenny,
yeah,
block
sorry,
him.
Jonathan.
Don't let him subscribe anymore.
See you later.
You got your money, you little mark. You can't have
a
it back.
Piece of shit. God.
Kick
you can't
rocks.
Have your one subscription back. I'm sorry, pal.
Go back to that. Damn controlled league or whatever bullshit that
yeah,
was.
Yeah, go back to that video game football league that I definitely don't watch. I definitely don't. Tej, round two. Here we go. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
All right. Your word is cyan.
Can you give me the definition?
The definition of cyan is a greenish-blue color, which is one of the primary subtractive colors complementary to red. It's one of those things that in cartridges, there's always a cyan.
Oh, great.
At least in cartridges I've been using for
this
printing.
This is going to be a complete guess. Cyan. Hold on. Let me look like I know what I'm doing.
Mike can also use an SN.
SC. AIAN.
Tej, that is incorrect.
Yeah, man.
That is incorrect.
For a word like four
I
can
tell it by
got...
Maggie's face.
For a word
use
with
that
four
SC,
letters,
Maggie
you
went,
got five of them wrong.
How do you spell that?
Cyan is spelled C-Y-A-N.
Oh my God, I literally got every letter wrong.
There's a C in there. There's a C and an N.
I feel like that one was too hard, personally. I feel like...
Damn it.
Oh, that makes me scared.
This is
that third round got me nervous.
I only had the 8 box of crayons. We never got the 64 box. I blame my parents for this.
Oh, man.
It's right, classist. Well, asking for cyan is classist.
We'll run it back. Your word is aquamarine. Is that
is that my word?
No.
No. No. Yeah, Maggie, we already gave you round two word. We have David Roth to wrap up round two. And David Roth, this is a personal favorite word of mine. Your word is turducken.
Oh, nice. A word that is new since I was born. Which is
it's
great.
A real one. It's real and it's new.
P-U-R-D-U-C-K-E-N, right?
That is how you spell turducken, a.k.a. John Madden's favorite Thanksgiving meal.
Yeah, because I'm pretty sure he invented that as far as I'm concerned. Like,
he
I,
absolutely
I never...
did.
There is some Thanksgiving game where he like he didn't really carve it, but he like cut one with his hands. Like he used his hands.
Yo,
he
ripped it off, didn't it?
Yeah,
yeah,
it was.
He fucking chopped it in half. It was insane.
Yeah.
Oh, God bless John Madden. I hope he's riding a Madden bus.
Is he alive? Yeah, he's still alive.
Yeah,
right?
I was just about to ask that.
He's alive.
Good for him.
On the, yeah, do you remember when he used to give commentary in the Madden games and then they gave it to that racist radio host instead?
Deep drive.
The racist radio.
That doesn't narrow it down at all.
Anthony Castellanos with a deep drive.
Yeah. Oh, God.
Or whatever. I can't believe I already forgot that meme.
Yeah, Tom Brennan called Madden.
They gave it to Tom Brennan.
Or he's like a Colts radio announcer.
It was a Colts radio dude who's like real MAGA now. I can't remember his name.
I don't know. It doesn't matter. We'll figure it out. Later.
Before we get too in the weeds on sports, which I know everyone is very ready to get into, it's round three of the Faded Drunk Spelling Bee. Here we go. We're starting from the top. Luis, we're back to you and your word in the beginning of round three of this, our Faded Drunk Spelling Bee, is dissuasion.
On. Can I get that in a sentence, Mike?
The basketball game was an attempted dissuasion for him leaving the company.
Absolute money in the bank right there.
There we go.
Oh, God.
If you can't get it off that, I mean, Luis, I'm not even sure. That was perfect.
Okay. D-I-S-S-U-A-S-S-I-O-N.
Luis, you had an extra S at the back end. Yeah, that is
fuck, I wasn't sure if I needed one.
Oh, incorrect.
S went and gave it to you.
It looks like David's still your boss.
S-S-U-A-S-I-O-N.
Damn S's. Damn me every time.
Too many S's.
It's why I can't spell embarrassing either.
Yeah. Is it two at the end of that? I should know that.
It is. I have spelled that wrong enough times to now know that it is two.
Oof. Hey, you know what? Everyone's got a word like that. My friend lost to the word jambalaya in the middle school spelling bee, and we still give him shit for it because there's no U's in jambalaya, which it's a genuine tricky word.
It's all A's.
All A's across the board. But anyway, shout out to Danny Glass. Sorry you lost that spelling.
And the next word is jambalaya.
Yeah, the next word is jambalaya. Pulling references from Lewis M. Clyde Middle School. But no, Maggie, you're up now. Round three. Absolutely locked in. Your word is parallelogram. I just like golf. It's very quiet.
P-A-R-A-L-L-E. L-O-G-R-A-M.
That's how you spell parallelogram. That is correct. Maggie May.
Parallelogram. God damn,
even
bro.
With Danny fucking coughing on her backswing like a fucking...
Oh, this shit got me nervous.
It's so quiet right now.
It was quiet. I just thought it was quiet. Here we go. Number three, Chris. Your word in round three of this our Faded Drunk Spelling Bee is corollary.
Oh, no, absolutely not.
you can take a pass. I'm kidding. There are no passes.
No, there are no passes. Can you give me a definition?
The definition of corollary is a proposition that follows from parentheses and is often appended to one already proved. Honestly, I don't even know what that means. That's on me. Yeah, does anyone know a better definition?
That made me more confused.
We're all good, Mike. Yeah. Mike, I need a sentence. I want a sentence, Mike.
There was a corollary stipulation in their contract.
I mean, that didn't really help me either.
That didn't help at all. I don't even think that's the right usage of that word, but it's fine. I'm going in.
Sure, it's like
go in, Chris. Go in.
C-O-R-O-L-L-E-R-O. I have Lauren. Whatever, I'm wrong.
Finish it.
Hold on. All right,
yeah, finish it.
C-O-R-O-L-L-E-R-Y.
Oof.
A-R-Y.
A-R-Y. So A-R-Y. One letter off. That is incorrect. Very close.
Refill.
Very close. Yeah. Took him with gas. Here we go. Who are we up to? Ellory, round three. Here we go. Are you ready?
Oh, I'm so nervous. That was a tough one.
Don't worry. I mean, yeah, it's round three. We're moving it up a little bit, but it's okay. This word, you got it. Here we go. Your word is concierge.
Okay, I was actually a concierge at a dog hotel once upon a time. That was my official title.
Is that is that where
you hold on one sec? You finally said a sentence more believable than I met Johnny Manziel at a pool and he was rude to me.
Well, my boss was really rude and he was a Cosby apologist.
Oh God.
Wait, real quick, what does a concierge at a dog hotel do? Because aren't concierges like
I scoop dog shit. That was my real job.
Got it. I was like, are you booking them restaurant reservations?
Yeah, like calling them cars.
Although there was a lot of like Instagram.
Calling them escorts.
Calling them escorts.
This had to have happened in LA, right? Like this was like the D Hotel or something. Yeah.
And some of the dogs had commercial agents that had the dogs on like all liquid diets. It was a really weird rule.
That's a real thing because I was walking my dog. I also live in LA. I was walking my dog and two different women when she was a puppy independently asked me if my dog had representation, which obviously no, because I'm not a crazy person.
Follow up though, man.
There's lots of money to be made. I met a lot of dogs on Xanax.
Yeah, I just want to say if anyone wants to represent Clyde, my DMs are open.
As are mine for Dakota.
Also, Ellory, is that's where you started giving the dogs wine, right? That's where that practice began.
I was like, how do we kill all these dogs so I can go? Okay, are you ready?
And here we are. Concierge, I'm ready.
CONCIERGE, concierge.
That is how you spell concierge. That is correct.
Oh. Cheers.
Boom. We're cooking with it. Round three. I have no idea who's in the lead, who's not. This is a tight one.
It's me. Don't worry about it.
Don't spoil it, Mike. Don't
not
spoil
me.
It.
As John, Larry Bird up. Said, which one of you motherfuckers is coming in second?
There we go. Wow. Hell yes. All right, Shocker, you're up. So you gotta back that shit up.
Oh, I'm gonna miss it now, and it's gonna be really embarrassing.
And your word in round three is sycophantic.
Sycophantic. Okay, wait. S Y C O P H A N T I C. Sycophantic.
That is how you spell sycophantic. There it is. Boom.
I've called enough people sycophants in my life.
There we go.
Last time Shocker was so drunk, he was quoting Larry Bird, but just asking where his tractor was.
Mike, you get suspended from Twitter for calling people sycophants, right? Well, like for saying you want to punch sycophants in the head, shoulders.
I don't know what you're talking about.
No, you got suspended from Twitter for asking an LA city councilman to eat a fist, right? No, that was Zach asked Mitch McConnell to bite a bullet. Never mind.
No, I got in trouble for saying I was going to kick Mitch O'Farrell into the sun.
Oh, he's my councilman.
He
deserved that.
Important message. You're doing God's work there. Like, that's people need to know that. Mm. So.
Also, Twitter should know you. He can't reach the sun. No one's ever been to the sun before.
I'll like barely get him out of the fucking atmosphere. Like,
I don't know. He's
not gonna reach the sun.
Listen, if Tom Brodude can throw a rock into the sun, Mike can kick Mitch O'Farrell into the sun.
I believe.
Tom Brodude.
May he rest in peace.
Yeah.
Noted 76ers fan Sophia, are you ready for round three? Which would be a round that Sixers fans I think would be happy about. It's a conference final. here we go. I mean,
then it's gonna like go off the rim from Kawhi and then go in and here we go.
Ben Simmons starts dating Kendall Jenner again, and it's like,
God. Don't dare, and don't put
I'm
that.
I'm not.
Don't put that evil into the world.
Don't you dare.
She's taken, right? Kendall's taken.
Devin
right?
Booker has her, and that is their business.
Oh, so the Suns are losing in round one. Got it.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
All right. Sophia, your word representing all the city of Philadelphia is piscatorial.
Piscatorial?
Piscatorial. Of or concerning fishermen or fishing.
And you're saying piscatorial, not pescatorial?
I'm saying piscatorial.
That's of interest for sure.
It is interesting.
I will say piscatorial.
That is how you spell piscatorial. That's correct. Yes.
Okay. Boom. Wow.
Happens every time.
This is too much pressure.
I was sweating, but now I'm drinking.
Oh, yeah. Cheers.
There we go. Cheers. Tiege, round three.
I'm ready.
It is not going to be some sort of color blue.
Thank God.
I'll lead with that. Your word is pejorative.
Pejorative. P-E-J-O-R-A-T-I-V-E. Pejorative.
That's correct. Boom.
Unbelievable.
Here it is. We're making good time, too. David Roth, we're already back to you. The end of round three. How you feeling? Hanging in?
You did a good job putting annoying words in this round. Ones with, like, two L's and stuff. That's what I was really looking forward to.
Two L's. Let's see. Do I got any other extra? I got some annoying words left. All right, David, the last word of round three is going to be intransigence.
Intransigence?
Intransigence.
So.
Refusal to change one's views or to agree about something, which doesn't apply to anything in this modern times, but what a word.
I think that it is I-N-T-R-A-N-S-I-G. Intransigence.
Oh, no, I'm sorry. Intransigence.
Intransigent. Yeah,
intransigence.
I said a non-word. I-N-T-R-A-I-N-S-I-G-E-N-C-E.
That is how you spell intransigence, a real American word.
I almost made up an amazing word there. It was like three letters away.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Roth, is your prowess tonight because two guys are doing things in baseball? Wade Miley has a no-hitter into the ninth, and Sean Mania has a perfect game through five.
That's fantastic.
Sean Mania, a great MLB The Show 21 pitcher.
Yeah.
Dog, I fucking hate playing against
Sean
that dude.
Mania.
Yeah, because he throws only in the bottom part of the zone.
And he's perfect through five.
Also,
somehow,
Mike,
on a night that Wade Miley is pitching a no-hitter.
Yeah, absolutely. Hit me up on that.
What a goddamn world. All right, before we get too in the weeds, even though I do want to see if someone throws a goddamn no-hitter tonight, here we go. Round four, the last round of the preliminary round.
Oh, I'm out.
This is it. This is the last round to get points. It's what?
I was going to say, has anyone missed a word? But then I remember we had one.
Yeah.
No, two of us.
Yes, two.
All right. But thanks.
Shocker. I will come fight you.
Coming in talking a bunch of shit.
No comment.
Mike, look, Shocker. It's Shocker's the bad guy this time. It's not me yet.
It was only a matter of time.
There you go. It's the Duke in you. But here we go. You got four points for getting a word round this round. So even if you got a word wrong recently, who knows? You can still make the finals. Final four people make it. We're back to the top. Luis, round four.
I don't like going first.
I know. I'm sorry. We were going to go serpentine, but people don't like serpentine. They don't like the back and forth snake effect of it. But, you know.
It's fine.
This is just how it goes. Your word.
Danny, you need to put your foot down and stop being bullied. This is always happens. Every goddamn game
bullied.
You get.
He just
you start
I didn't
fucking
bully.
Apologizing
I just made
for
comment.
Anybody. He just
God
he was
damn
just
it,
nice
Danny.
And apologized.
Get control of shit. I know, but I just like to give Danny first. Shit. It's fun.
Yeah, people don't like to go first. I get it. Your word, Luis, is braggadocio.
Okay, hold on. I got to try to write this down. Can you say it again?
Braggadocio, empty boasting or bragging.
And you know what, Mike, because this might be my last word, give me a sentence, buddy.
I'm trying to think, because I know braggadocious, I could use that in a sentence.
Use Danny, that in a sentence. It's I know what's not there in that one.
Yeah. Fucking
Mike Malloy is braggadocious. End of
you
sentence.
You got it, Mike.
Well, no, braggadocious.
Shocker, shut the fuck
like,
up.
His shit talk about the spelling bee was simply braggadocio.
There you go. Okay. Oh, God. B-R-A-G-A-D-O-C-I-O.
Mike, I think you got it.
Did we
count it?
Double G?
There's two G's.
Did he say two G's
he
or one
not.
G?
He said
I
one G.
I said one G.
Appreciate you guys keeping me honest. That
I said two.
That
no,
is incorrect.
I heard one.
I heard one.
I said two.
I heard one as well. I heard one as well. Oh, no.
You said I got it.
I know.
No,
yeah. No.
You fucking dickhead.
Then I, you know, hey, every now and then you need to phone a friend. You need to ask the audience, and I beefed it. I'll say.
Wait,
it.
Could I have asked the audience?
maybe for future ones, but not this time, unfortunately. That is incorrect. I don't know if you're gonna make the final. Who knows? That's for Mike to say. Mike might fuck up the math and you might be in first.
I got a little spreadsheet. I know how to do
it. We'll see. All right. Well, here we go. We're moving on to Maggie May. Round four. Hasn't blinked yet in this spelling bee. Absolutely destroying. Your word is accoutrements.
She knows it. I can see it in her.
Yeah. Maybe potentially pronounced. Is it pronounced accoutrement? Yeah. Here we go.
Accoutrement.
Accoutrements. When it's plural, I have it plural. Accoutrements. But that's
okay.
Here we go.
I'm not sure about this one. A C All right. A C C O U T R E M E N T S.
I heard that one. That was correct. That was correct. I heard every letter.
We did that.
Wow.
God damn.
Woo! Okay. All right.
So Maggie's perfect through four so far.
Louise. That was awesome. All right, Chris.
Here comes a misspelled word. Let's do it.
Hey, you never know.
No, I do know, but let's get it over with.
All right, let's get it over with. Your word is insouciant.
No, it's infused with an insouciant hint of lemon zest.
Ooh.
I know how the word. I know how to use the word, but I don't know how to spell the word. Give me a definition so I can buy some time.
The definition
free
of
from
insouciant.
Concern, worry, or anxiety.
No, that is not the way I know how to use that word, but that's fine.
Yeah, you were talking about lemons. I was just like, what?
I did. Insouciant.
It sounded nice.
Lemons are pretty carefree.
When you think about it, yeah.
Whoo, boy, there's some C's and some S's, and I don't know where they go. Insouciant. I-N-S-C-U-C-I-E-N-T.
Chris, that is incorrect.
Yeah, I know. I knew going in. I knew immediately when you said the word I was going
to
be
incorrect. It's my job to say it. The correct definition, the correct spelling of insouciant is I-N-S-O-U-C-I-A-N-T.
Well, I got that real wrong. That was excessively wrong.
Hey, man, there's only one way to get it wrong, and it's wrong. But you know what? It's a hell of an effort. Still in the running, I believe.
I can't imagine that's true.
I mean, I got to say something. I don't know. All right, round four, Ellory, we're back to you. Your word in the fourth round of this, our faded spelling bee, is animadversion.
Can you use it in a sentence?
I can't, but Mike can.
Can I get the definition and then can you use it in a sentence?
Yes.
I can't even say the word, I don't think, Danny.
The word is
animaniacs. What is it?
The word is animadversion, and the definition is an unfavorable or censorious comment. So
you shouldn't be able to use a word I don't know the definition of in the definition of another word. What was that?
Which one? Sure. Unfavorable? Oh, censorious. Yeah, censorious is a tough one.
It's animadversion.
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 Okay, so it's
an unfavorable comment. So, like, Tom Brenneman said an animadversion and then got fired, and then Castellanos hit a deep fly to left.
So I'm gonna guess it's animation adversion. That's gonna be so A N I M. And then adversion, A-D-V-E-R-S-I-O-N.
That is correct.
Wow.
Wow, what a hit.
Also a perfect score for Ellery thus far.
Unbelievable. I think we got two finals members, I believe. That was, here we go, wow. Animadversion. Still don't know what that word means, and I just said it. Shocker.
What's up?
Round four, here we go.
Let's do it.
Your word in round four is catachresis.
Catachresis. Can I get the definition?
The definition of catachresis is misuse or strained use of words, as in a mixed metaphor occurring either in error or for rhetorical effect.
literally never heard this word before or seen it. So we're just going to shoot in the dark. Catacresis? Am I saying that right?
Catacresis.
I just spelled it so poorly in Google that it couldn't come up with a definition. It couldn't come up with an example.
Results.
Nothing exists.
Catacresis. C-A-T-I C-R-E-C Catacresis. So Catacresis. O-U-S? That's not right.
Shocker, that is incorrect.
Yeah, no, I have no fucking idea how to spell this word.
Catacresis is spelled C-A-T-A-C-H-R-E-S-I-S. Catacresis.
Fuck this word.
It's not an easy word. Fuck this word. I agree.
Yeah, congratulations, Shocker. You're the first person to ever lose two spelling bees.
And you know what? I was.
You made history, Bubba.
And I was not blackout drunk this time, so that's even worse.
Well, we still got a little ways to go. You can do it.
Yeah, you still got Dakota.
You still got to drink every time they spell it right, and you got to you got to drink for spelling wrong right now.
Yeah, that's true.
Just took it. So, cheers.
It's round four.
I'm freaking out.
Freaking the geek out. Don't worry. They're all hard words. We're all going to get them
I've been
wrong.
Googling them and I'm getting them wrong. So
the ones where
I had never
you know what?
Seen or heard that last one before. And I use obnoxious words way more often than I should in the stuff that
he
I
really read. Does.
Yeah. Appreciate it.
Hey, I got
a really good
word
though. I like that word. It's just a fucker.
I got I was using Pro Spelling Reference was the database that I've been using to get all my fancy schmancy words. Thanks to Pro Spelling.
I'm using that in my next soccer blog. I already forgot what it means, but let's do it.
Catacresis, misuse or strained use of words. All right, that's actually.
Yeah, like all right. To mean drunk. Yeah.
Yes. Oh, yes. That makes a lot more sense. All right, Sophia, your word in this fourth round is sobriquet.
Okay.
Sobriquet. The definition is a nickname.
Oh, I know this one actually.
It's very confident.
Oh shit.
S O B R I. I can't guarantee that I can spell it, but I know the word. S O B R I Q U E T.
Got it.
Sophia, you do know how to spell the word. That is correct.
Ooh. Okay. Oh my god.
Can you tell me what that word means? Because I'm a dummy.
It's like a nickname.
It means a nickname. Like the Greek freak is Giannis Antetokounmpo's sobriquet.
Well done.
Damn, I felt great after saying that sentence. Damn, big words rule. Shout out to big words. Perfect game got busted. I'm sorry to all the A's fans out there, unless Sean Monet is not there anymore.
All four of you.
Tej?
I'm ready.
Round four, here we go. He's ready. Your word is eudaimonic.
Say that one more time.
Eudaimonic. Eudaimonic.
Eudaimonic, man.
I'm going to need a definition of that.
That's one of those guys from Game of Thrones with no penises, right?
Yes. It is a person with no penis on Game of Thrones, or pertaining or conductive to happiness is the definition of eudaimonic.
Pertaining to happiness?
Pertaining or conductive to happiness.
It doesn't sound like it has anything to do with demons. Okay.
It doesn't feel like it, yeah. Eudaimonic.
All right. Let's go. I feel like if I spell it how it sounds, I'm going to miss it. So I'm going to go different. Let's go U-D-I-M-O-N-I-C. Eudaimonic.
Tej, that is incorrect.
What is it?
The correct spelling is E-U-D-E-M-O-N-I-C. Eudaimonic. Eudaimonic.
Ugh.
This is a tough one. Maybe, I guess EU might be opposite of demonic. I don't know. I don't know words, but I'm hosting a spelling bee. David Roth, we're back to you.
Hey, hi. How's it going? How's the spelling bee going so far?
Hanging in there. It's good. How are you doing?
Still? Yeah, about the same. About the same as when we last spoke.
JC?
Yeah. All right. The Mets won.
Nice.
since we last.
Did they?
Yeah, they did. I was surprised too, but yeah, it did happen.
Did who's DeGrom pitching or no?
No, they had one of their lesser starters pitch, and he walked in three runs in the first inning, and then they came back and won. Francisco Lindor hit a homer. A lot of the That's stuff delightful. That the people watching this show care a lot about.
Yeah. Oh yeah. No. After the show, we're doing a breakdown of Hugh Quattlebaum's.
Like a
first week.
We're gonna run down the bullpen. How's everybody letter grades for every reliever? Yep.
Mel Kiper. Shout out to Hugh Quattlebaum, a real human being. What a name. Here we go. Last round of the preliminary rounds of the Drunk Spelling Bee. Your word is desuetude.
Oh, wow. This one I think I've seen. The one that Tej got, I had never encountered either. So this is
I sent you the word list before.
Yeah, I appreciate it. desuetude. What does it mean?
It means the state of being no longer used or practiced. Desuetude.
Can you spell it for me?
I can.
D-E-S-U-E-T-U-D-E.
That is how you spell desuetude. Right. Yeah. Wowie zowie. Oh. And that brings us to the end of the preliminary rounds.
Very impressive.
Of the Faded Drunk Spelling Bee. That was incredible. I threw some hard ones in there. This was so much harder than last time.
It looks like
we
did get the no-hitter, by the way.
Fucking A. Wade
fucking Miley. Fucking hell. Mike.
All right.
Who do we get in the finals?
Let's announce our four finalists. For the final round, the lightning round, we have Maggie May. We have Ellory Smith. We have Sophia Benoit. And David Roth, moving on to the final lightning round.
Nice.
Here we go. Thank you to everyone at Shocker, Tej, Chris Cubas.
We did it.
It's been a pleasure, Luis.
We did it.
Yeah, obviously,
Kenny will probably suggest that you do because it will probably fuck his shit up if you leave. Right, Kenny? Or fucking release that.
Yeah.
No, I'm staying to heckle Roth.
I've got a nice buzz going. I'm going to make fun of anyone. Yeah, exactly. That's great.
I'm going to step outside for a second. I'll come back in time to boo David Roth.
No, I appreciate that. Thank you.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
That's what I feed off.
All right, so to the finalists, congratulations to the finalists. Unbelievable. Maggie, Ellory, Sophia, David. Here we go. This is how it works. We're basically doing it like we've been doing the regular B where, excuse me, I'm getting emotional. we're just going to reset every time until we get one person. So everything is going to be like a new round. So we're just going to start. We'll go Maggie, Ellory, then Sophia, then David. If you get a word wrong, you're out. And then we just rinse, repeat. So it'll be four words and then boom. And the next round, four words until there's one left.
Yeah. So if everybody spelled the word wrong in that round, it would reset.
Reset.
But like, otherwise, you know, if two people spell it right in this round, they move on. The other two are out.
Yes. All right. I think we're waiting on Maggie, I believe. So, yeah.
Mike, can you walk us through your Averna shelf?
My what now?
Your Averna shelf that you got down there on the bottom.
Oh, yeah
Mike.
Fancy liqueurs.
It's just Averna.
Oh, it's just Averna? All right. I didn't know if you had like
a series of Avernas. No, I don't care for that much. I just all my like base liquors are underneath. You can't see them. This is just all the like the mix shits.
Delicious.
You know?
Did anyone smoke for this as well? I'm curious because there was a couple people that were pretty high. Ellery.
I mean, yeah, I've had
a few
blunts.
I took some edibles.
Nice, amazing. I'm just always curious, like the previous winners, usually mostly drunk people. Previous winners, the winner of this will be joining. Iffy Wadiway, Josh Gondelman, Mo Henry, and David Roth.
Josh Gondelman. No, thank
you. That's true. He does, and he. That's fair. And Josh did do a deep, a severe amount of cocaine to get through that
spelling. Oh yeah, that was the prize. We gave away a big bag of cocaine, and Josh just got way. We couldn't do it again after that.
He abused his privilege. You know, Josh, you're not welcome back here. We don't do cocaine on the show anymore.
He's
sorry,
banned.
Buddy.
No, this is a family friendly. This is a Christian.
We drink
program.
Dunks, but we don't do cocaine. Thanks,
he's
bud.
So
thanks
nice that he texted me before this, so being sweet. Like, "Good luck." Like,
aww.
That's very sweet.
He's so sweet.
That's why everybody lies on him constantly, because he's
hilarious.
He also had a shirt that says, "I don't do cocaine," and I've also never done cocaine, so I bought it as well. And I literally, like I've never done it, and the one time I was offered it as a full adult, I cried. Like, and all my friends were so embarrassed for me that they were like, let's never bring that up again. So I feel a kindred spirit with Josh. Good for him.
Yeah. Josh is a modern Jimmy Carter in that he's too nice to be president.
Yes. But would do a great job if given the task.
He's like one person who could stumble into the presidency, I feel like, and it would be like a comedy where you'd be like, what is happening? Why is
yeah, Sophia, like,
I feel safe with Josh in charge. He's not going to do anything bad.
I'll do.
I would what I'm saying is I would watch a remake of Head of State starring Josh Gondelman.
Yes.
For sure.
Yes. yes.
Just green screen him over Chris Rock. Keep Bernie Mac. Keep everybody else. Just put Josh in there.
And Bernie Mac smacks the shit out of him every scene. Josh. All right, Maggie's back, so I think we can start the final round of this goddamn baited spell.
I'm sorry.
No worries. We're hanging out. We're talking about doing cocaine with Josh Gondelman. It was great. Josh, no, he doesn't do coke. Now I feel like defending him.
Not anymore.
Not after this Sox 1-0-4. Okay, here we go. We're starting from the top, so we're starting with you, Maggie. First word of this final round is letterograde.
Who?
Letterograde.
Can I hear it in a sentence?
The crab walks in a letterograde fashion.
The definition of letterograde is having a sideways manner of moving as a crab. So Mike just ripped that straight from the head.
I don't know how to read. I knew it.
Can I have country of origin?
Letterograde? I don't see country, so I don't know.
Maryland?
Greece, maybe? Yeah.
Balmer. It's from Balmer.
Letterograde is still the word. But there's no time limit, so what am I even saying?
A drink before answering. The double
drink. That's awesome.
Extremely power move.
Loading up.
Letterograde.
Oh, that's your cousin, isn't it, Maggie? Is that your cousin? Letterograde?
Yeah, Letterograde went to beauty school. Letterograde. Letterograde. Letterograde.
Maggie, that is incorrect.
I'm out of this show right now. Watch this.
She's gone.
If everybody else gets it wrong, you're back in. But who knows? Yeah.
Everyone else has got a whiff. But that.
I'm going back and doing my laundry.
A Mike Malloy goodbye, as Maggie May would do. The correct spelling of letterograde is Letterigrade. Letterograde. That is a tricky word. All right, here we go.
I'm going to eat some crabs just to like make up for how horrible that word is.
That is a brutal word.
I'm going to eat some crab tomorrow and eat the fuck out of it. I'm going to be like, you letterograde motherfucker.
All right, here we go. Ellory, final round. Your first word. Your first word is concessionaire.
Like somebody who runs a concession stand?
A person, group, or company to whom a concession has been granted.
Close enough, I guess.
Yeah.
It's easy.
But like somebody holding an event, essentially.
Okay, yeah. Let's think it out slowly.
Okay, I'm going to assume that it's like spelled like concession stand. So like C-O-N-C-S-S-I-O-N, the concession, and then air is A-I-R-E typically. So that should be concessionaire.
Yeah. Oh yeah.
Yeah, that's right. It. That's concessionaire. We weren't sure if you were.
Did y'all forget you were?
I thought Mike was gonna say it. I said, Ellery, that is correct.
That's two easy ass words put together.
Yeah, I got a cheap one.
All right.
I'm just, the tequila's hit, so I'm just going to be talking shit from the sideline.
That's fair. That's fair. No, that's
fuck
fair.
Yes.
That's the only reason I'm still here. So
usually
I respect
that's
that.
From round
Louis, what
one.
Are you drinking
usually
there?
Yeah. Usually by round two, everybody's screaming at Danny and calling him for him to be canceled.
Which
this
again,
this is an agave spiked seltzer, Rob.
Yeah, again. Okay. Oh.
I've got the same one.
Yeah, that tequila.
Did you open it?
Yeah, it's fucking strong.
It really is.
This is
I blame that for my failures with double letters tonight.
I'm on my second bottle of champagne. So I'm not ready for this.
Not ready for it.
You keep saying that, but like a good author, you are creating a narrative.
Correctly, yeah.
I've gotten every single, everyone else's words I've gotten wrong, and I think I've only gotten really lucky, and I'm going to maintain that. I think Ellory and I have both gotten incredibly lucky.
Don't point it out, Sophia. It's working.
Sorry, but I really, not to be part of call out culture, but I think we got lucky.
Call it out. Sophia, your word in the first round of the final round of the Faded Spelling Bee is obstreperous.
Obstreperous.
Resisting control or restraint in a difficult manner, unruly. Obstreperous.
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 Obstreperous. Okay, could I, obstreperous?
Obstreperous.
Okay, this is...
Found this one out too.
Obstreperous. I have one question letter, and here we go. Okay, O-B-S-T-R-E-P-O-R-I-O-U-S. It might not have that
Sophia,
I.
That is incorrect.
It's the
incorrect.
I.
There is no I.
Fuck it the is, I. I knew it. Fucker.
It is O-B-S-T-R-E-P-E-R-O-U-S.
Fuck. Fuck the Greek people and the Latin people that made the language. I'll say it.
I'll
say
it. I'm not saying it.
Noisy and difficult to control is the Google definition, which is what I'm about to be.
Yeah,
to this goddamn show. Word.
Hell yes.
Okay. Well, that was a loss for.
Well,
I think
we're down to two. Ellory and David. David, if you get this wrong, Ellory wins. If you get it right, we go to the next round.
All right.
Ooh.
David, your word is physiognomy.
A really solid sobriety test. I'm gonna write it down. That looks decently right. P-H-Y-S-I-O-G-N-O physiognomy. P-H-Y-S-I-O-G-N-O-M-Y.
That don't sound right at all.
That's correct.
100% right, Peggy. 100% right.
Physiognomy.
My uncle had a physiognomy.
Fuck you, man.
I just said I need a physiognomy.
I need a gross gas in protest.
Yeah, my shit cut out for a minute. That sounded wrong.
Unbelievable. All right, well, we're moving on to round two of the final round. It's Ellory versus David. Here we go. Oh my, I'm feeling a little something. Here we go.
Oh, I'm really
all right, that's great. That is the whole. I'm gonna take another sip before we go. Ellory, round two of the final round. Your word is ichthyophagus.
Oh my god, dude.
What? Go, Ellory, you can do it, girl. You can do it.
No one can spell this word.
I'm just seeing you. Can you put it in a sentence for me, or can you give me the definition and then a sentence, please?
The definition of ichthyophagus is fish eating. So I guess I am ichthyophagus. I enjoy eating fish. Ichthyophagus. Ichthyophagus.
We're going to need a country of origin on this shit, too. So.
That's actually fair.
That's definitely Nordic.
Norway.
Okay. Can you say it for me, really, in three syllables, really slowly?
Say it very slow.
Ichthyophagus.
Is it theophagus or veophagus?
Ichthyophagus. Ichthyophagus.
Okay. Thank you. Let's see. Ick. Can you say it for me one more time?
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
I'm sorry.
Ichthyophagus. Ichthyophagus.
Okay. I-C-K-T-H-Y-O-P-H-O-G-U-S.
Ellery, a valiant effort, but that is incorrect.
How is the key telling how it's spelled?
That sounded right to me.
Yes. It sounded good. It sounded good. It sounded right off the bat. There's two off. It was two off. The correct spelling is I-C-H-T-Y-O-H-A-G-O-U-S.
That's what she said. It sounded good.
Yeah. That's close enough. Can we do close enough in the spelling bee?
Yeah,
I tried to spell it.
You spelled it right. You got it.
Damn it.
I got it wrong in two ways.
It's just racism happening right now because I'm on your team.
This spelling bee is anti-woman, and I'll say it.
Yeah, we're finally here. It's also a little racist. I'm just taking that without Maggie getting a term, but it's a little racist.
Thank you.
Danny. See, it happened on you. Everybody's mad at you. As soon as everybody drops out, everybody calls for Danny's fucking head. It's great. I love it.
You know what? I'll take it.
Finally, the heat's off me.
I'm just saying, three women got their word wrong in a row. I don't know.
Yeah, David, a lot of doesn't seem right to me.
Three women made it to the finals?
No. Don't rewrite this.
Oh, wow.
All I'm going to say is that the Latino did not make it to the finals. It feels a little problematic. We've had a
Panamanian winner. We've had an Italian winner.
I'm South American. That's different.
Not an Arab winner because you're racist against Arabs. I wasn't going to say it, but...
Arabs and Venezuelans were being discriminated against.
Oh, yeah. I mean, if you're yelling at me, it's fine. As long as it's...
Louise, they hate OPEC countries. That's what it is.
Digging deep, and they're like, my grandma's from Jamaica, and I'm pretty sure y'all knew that. And that is
problematic. Yeah.
All I'm saying is that, David, if you get this word right, a white man will have won the spelling
bee.
My
responsibility here is
unacceptable.
I know what must be done.
This is a purse right now.
If you asked me to spell ichthyophagus again after you just spelled it 2 minutes ago, I would get it wrong in two different ways. So I'm not.
It was a tough one.
It's incredibly hard.
Tough. All right. Your word, David, for the W. And this isn't white favoritism, so please don't. I shouldn't have even said the word white favoritism. That was so stupid, Danny.
Y'all give him a word like jumping through the screen right now.
Yeah. Now spell Rolfman. White favoritism.
Yeah, I was going to say, like, spell your own middle name.
I mean, your word is sandwich. No, okay. Yeah. your word is phaeton.
I know this one, though. Why did you... Give me another one. Give me one I don't know.
You know Phaeton?
I think, right? P-H-A-E-T-O-N?
He's a fucking editor. God damn it.
David, spell that.
Oh, did I do it wrong?
P-H-A-E-T-O-N. Phaeton.
P-H-A-E-T-O-N.
Yes.
You said?
Maggie said it, too. But you want to say it, too? It's P-H-A-E-T-O-N,
that's incorrect.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, good.
Perfect. Okay,
yeah, good. All right, good. There's a future for
How's the word spelled?
I don't even see it on my page, Danny.
How's it spelled?
Word phaeton, part of a newspaper or magazine devoted to fiction, criticism, or light, is F-E-U-I-L-L-E.
Oh my God. Oh,
Jesus, that couldn't have been more wrong. Yeah. That was the most.
I feel like you should be eliminated for being so wrong.
Give me a different word. I know it, you little bullshit artist. You want to be on this show every damn 2 weeks.
That word is pronounced, anyway, that word is pronounced phaeton.
Yeah. I got a phaeton. I don't ride it much, but I'm going to.
No, a phaeton twice a week. Carriage.
All I did was Google the word, and the first thing that popped up, I clicked on it, and that's the definition.
I was traumatized by ichthyophagus or whatever because I went Greek on that instead of going. I overthought it. Well, now we get to do it again.
Now we get to run it back. Ellory is back in. This show is pro women. That's how it works. We're starting another final round. Unless Ellory loses, and then this show is very anti-women because we had a woman lose twice in the finals. We'll see. Here we go. Ellory, round three of the finals. Your word is zinciferous.
Oh,
geez.
Can I get a definition and a sentence?
Definition is something that is containing or yielding zinc.
Okay. I can work with that. So I'm
Mike, you got it.
The first half is zinc.
The rocks that they dug up, what was it? What was the fucking word, Danny? I don't even remember.
Zinciferous.
They had fucking zinc in it. I don't know. Fucking, you figure it out. I'm drunk and fucking high as shit.
Okay, so I'm going to guess that the first part of the word is zinc, and then it's going to be iferous. So Z-I-N-C-I-F-E-R-O-U-S.
Yeah, got it.
That is correct.
Yes!
Unbelievable. Amazing. What a hit.
I love women.
Women can do anything.
I've always been an ally, so Ellory, I hope you win.
David Roth. What?
Wearing
honestly, a lot of people saying being an ally is the bravest thing you can be.
True.
When you think about it. Because it's so selfless. Like, it's kind of, it's more brave. It's like, I don't gain anything from being a good guy, but I am.
David Roth, your word in this third round of the final round of the Faded Spelling Bee is ABCDarian.
You spelled it for him.
Huh? What just happened?
I don't even, are you talking about a channel?
Yeah, this sounds like a...
It is a subsidiary. The definition is a subsidiary owned by Disney Plus.
Farm?
That's true. Yes. This is Jake.
ABC.
Mike, you're looking at the word, right? You're looking at the word.
Yeah, it's to arrange alphabetically.
There it is. ABC Darian.
So alphabetically.
To arrange alphabetically.
Arrange alphabetically.
Is what alphabetically is.
Yes.
They're all in agreement on the alphabet being an important component of spelling this word. ABCDarian. There's no way that it can be this, but I can't think of why it would be anything else. Is it ABCDERIAN?
No.
David Roth, that is incorrect.
You're out!
All right. What is it?
The correct spelling of ABCDarian is ABECEDARIAN, which means Ellory Smith, you are the winner!
Ellory, our new champion.
Finally!
Yes.
This makes up for Hillary losing. This is a better than...
Yes.
Women have won before. If we've had like three of them and they've won.
This is the first one that I haven't won.
Yes, is the first one David Roth has never won of the two he has participated
in. I am so happy to not have to come. I'm inoculated as of like four days from now. Like, I have plans next Friday.
Yeah, I was going to say.
That part is not true.
Well, yeah, we've only booked these out virtually till June, and then it'll likely become, we'll fucking keep
We got one in July. Don't worry about it.
Ellory.
Oh, yeah, there's something being worked on that front. But, you know, Ellory, you're a new champion.
Unfortunately, you'll have to defend your title. Are you willing to come back and defend your title?
Yes.
All right.
Yeah.
Unbelievable.
This is such a big deal for your school.
But I'm willing to come back and hype up Ellory.
Yeah,
Maggie.
People in the chat. We need people going. Yeah. Let's
Again,
go.
As an ally, I will be here to support
Ellory.
I'm here
Ellory. To do it.
Yeah.
I'm here to do it.
Just like from you should have like everybody should have a manager like in wrestling, like somebody.
Ooh.
Like,
I will be Ellery's Paul Heyman.
Oh my god!
Sorry,
that
but
would actually
I'm dragging.
You know what? Fair.
All right. Well, guys, thank you so much for doing this. We really appreciate you coming in on a Friday night and just drinking with us and spelling these silly words. It really means a lot. You guys were all fantastic guests, and it's amazing that you guys all joined us. Thanks. One last cheers to all of you guys. One last cheers to everyone watching. Thank you for tuning in, as always. Thanks for watching this silly little show we're putting on. We'll be back in 2 weeks with our defending champ Ellory.
Thursday with happy hour. Don't
we'll be back with faded happy hour again.
Spend a lot of time doing.
With a bartender. Hey, I make drinks with you every. Yes, we got happy hour on Thursday.
Yeah.
We're
making. I can't wait till my buddy Jamie's out here drinking with me live in person. I miss him.
Yes, sir. I miss you too, pal. Thank you to everyone watching. Thank you to producer.
Oh, yeah. Sophia's on this Thursday. She's coming to get
drinks. Sophia's going to make drinks with us.
I am.
All right. Amazing. Well, Sophia, beautiful. I don't know. Do you know what you're making? Do you know?
Anything but tequila.
No, she's just guest
anything
drinking.
Anything but tequila.
So we'll figure the rest Lila, out. The bartender from. Or wait, no. Is that this week or the week after?
I don't know. All right. Well,
I don't know. We'll figure it out. Yeah. I don't know. I have it written down. Yeah, oh, yeah. Shocker, you're coming through, too. All right. Goodbye, everybody.
Wait, what am I coming through on?
Ellory, great job.
A couple weeks from now.
Sure, why not?
You nailed it, Ellory. Well done.
Ellory, you made me believe women can do things. Great job.
You guys did it. Congrats.
Women truly can have it all.